Good evening. Today we are going to see a condition called as Codner's phenomenon. Some of you might remember it from your undergraduate dermatology days. Codner's phenomenon gets its name from Heinrich Codner, who described it in 1878. So he described it in psoriasis. So, a short story about Codner. Codner was a German mycologist who did science the old-fashioned way, that is, using himself as a guinea pig. So there is a story of him dramatically lifting up his shirt in a medical meeting to show three different fungus on his chest. He had inoculated their cultures onto his chest to show that they are infective. Now, what is Codner's phenomenon? Codner's phenomenon is also called as isomorphic phenomenon. Refers to the occurrence of new lesions on uninvolved skin following trauma. Now the trauma can be a mechanical trauma, electrical trauma, can be a bite. The bite can be that of an insect or an animal, or even an inoculation can cause Codner's phenomenon. Codner's phenomenon occurs as early as 3 days or as late as 30 days. And the usual time frame is between 7 and 14 days. Now, what is the pathogenesis of Codner's phenomenon? Following an injury, there is a release of neuropeptides from the peripheral nerve endings and leading to the spread of the lesion. So it follows that the dermis has to be injured to get Codner's phenomenon, because the epidermis has got no blood or nerve supply. Now, what are the conditions where we get Codner's phenomenon? Usually there are infective conditions. First slide, please. This is molluscum contagiosum. You can see the new lesions occurring in a straight line. Next slide. This is a viral wart. We can see the lesions occurring right from here to here. The other conditions are lichen nidus, lichen sclerosis at atrophicans, and even xanthelasma papyrularum, pyoderma gangrenosum, bullous pemphigoid, and autoimmune disorders like psoriasis, lichen planus, and vitiligo can also show Codner's phenomenon. Next slide, please. This is a lichen planus showing Codner's, and this is in a prosal evolution. Now we know the cause, we know the pathogenesis, and what does it tell us clinically? When we see Codner's phenomenon, we know that the disease process is active. So what does that mean? When the disease process is active, we do not do any elective procedures like biopsies, and we do not ask the patient to undergo any elective procedures. And patient has also got to be careful and not sustain any injuries, because this new lesions can form. Now, just as we get new lesions following an injury, there is something called as reverse Codner's phenomenon, where lesions can disappear following an injury. That again is seen in psoriasis. And there is something called as remote reverse Codner's phenomenon, that is seen in vitiligo, where untreated patches of vitiligo develop repigmentation, and this is called remote reverse Codner's phenomenon. With that, I come to the end. Thank you.
What is the treatment?
Well, we do not treat Codner's phenomenon, we treat the basic condition. So the idea in presenting this is, when you see a patient with a Codner's phenomenon, we do not do any biopsies, and we do not do any elective procedures, and we know that disease process is active.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. Perumal, the past president, to hand over the certificate of appreciation to Dr. Stevens.